Hello learners, welcome. Today we shall be talking about a very important portion in financial accounting, that is depreciation. Now business organizations incur expenditure on fixed assets like land, building, machinery, equipment, tools, etc. And the benefit of these kinds of expenditure on fixed assets is derived for a long period of time. Now it is not possible that you charge the entire expenditure of these expenses on fixed assets to the current year profits. Then what will happen if you charge this amount in the profits of the current year? The profits of the current year will go down, and also the results would not be very consistent. That is, you will not be able to compare the profits for large number of years. And since the benefit is going to accrue to the business over a long period of time, therefore, it is beneficial and in the interest of the business that we charge these expenditure in small portions to the useful life of the asset. Now, this portion of the total cost of the fixed asset, which is charged to the profits for the current year as an expense, is what is referred to as depreciation. So, in this chapter, we shall be talking about the meaning and concept of depreciation, the causes of depreciation, objectives of depreciation, and the factors affecting depreciation. So, let us start learning about, first of all, what is depreciation. As I just explained to you, that it's an amount which is incurred by the business organization on their fixed assets, and the benefit is going to arise over a long period of time. So, depreciation is an expense which is charged during a year for reduction in the value of fixed assets arising because of the normal wear and tear and obsolescence. Now, what is normal wear and tear? Normal wear and tear is when the value of the asset declines either because of its use or because of passage of time. And obsolescence is again the reduction in the value of the asset due to reasons such as the change in technology, fashion, taste, and market conditions. Now, let us go further and understand that what are the causes of depreciation. Now, let us understand that how does the normal wear and tear lead to reduction in the value of the asset. It is primarily because of two reasons. First is due to usage, and second is due to the passage of time. As every asset has a particular useful life of the asset in which it is going to give us production or give us services. And when we keep on using it constantly over the years, there is a decline in the value of the asset, or the worth of that asset decreases. So this is the usage, or due to the usage of the asset. Similarly, the second reason could be because of passage of time. Even if you are not putting the asset to any use, it is lying idle, but because of elements of nature, wind, sun, rain, or any other physical deterioration, again the value of the asset goes down. For example, let us assume that you buy a car. What will happen? If you are using it, then also there will be a decline in the value of the asset. Or even if you are not putting the car to use, it is just standing outside your house, you will not be able to get the same amount as you paid it in the showroom at the time when you bought the car. So, it is either because you are constantly using the car, or even if it is not using usage of the car and it is lying outside your house, but because of the passage of time, the value of the car declines. So, this is what is meant by the normal wear and tear of the asset. The second cause of depreciation is obsolescence. Obsolescence again leads to a decline or a reduction in the value of the asset, and it arises because of two reasons. First is development of improved or superior equipment, and second is the change in fashion, style, taste, or market conditions. Now, due to the development of improved or superior equipment, what happens is that the earlier assets that were put to use are discarded because now you have better and improved version. For example, steam engines became obsolete with the arrival of diesel and electric locomotives, or similarly, the color TVs replaced the black and white TVs. So, as a result, when you are discarding a particular asset because now you have better and improved version, that what is referred to as obsolescence. Obsolescence can also arise due to the change in fashion, style, taste or market condition. So again, it results in a decline in the demand of certain goods and services because of the changes in any of these. It could be because of change in fashion or style or customer preferences, taste and the market conditions, like what we have it for our change in clothing, housing or other lifestyle items. So as a result, they are discarded and we start using better versions. Now we proceed further and understand that what are the objectives or aims of depreciation. Why is it an important and a relevant concept in financial accounting? Now, depreciation has a very, very important impact in terms of depicting or showing the business true financial position. So, from the point of view of business, it is very essential that you are able to portray the true financial position, which is the prime motive of any business to display the accounting records and to display the balance sheet truly and correctly. Second objective or aim which depreciation tries to fulfill is to retain funds in the business for replacement of the new assets. Now, let us again discuss and learn in detail what is meant by the true financial position of the business. Now, these fixed assets have an effective working life. And what is depreciation? It is a gradual decline or loss in the value of the asset. Now, if depreciation is not provided, then what will happen? That the profit and loss account that discloses the profits for the business through your profit and loss account will not reveal the true profits made during the accounting year. So, you are using the assets, deriving the benefits, but you are not charging them as an expense. So, as a result, the profits that you are displaying in your profit and loss account will not give you the true and the final state of affairs. Similarly, when you make use of the assets, the value of the assets over the year, it has to go down. And again, if it is not charged to the balance sheet under the respective fixed assets appearing in the balance sheet, the value would be overvalued for fixed assets. So again, it will not give you the true financial status of the business in terms of the fixed assets displayed in the business. So that is why it is very essential and an important component for the business to provide for depreciation every year and charge it as an expense in your books of accounts. The second most important objective which depreciation provides for the business is for the purpose of replacement of asset. Now, as we've just learned, that depreciation is an expense which is to be charged on the asset, and this amount of expense is not paid to any third party or to an outsider. What you are doing is that from your total profits earned every year, you are keeping aside a part of your profit in the profit and loss account as accumulated depreciation funds or accumulated depreciation reserves. And year after year, this becomes a huge amount. Now, since these assets have a certain useful life, and after that, once their productivity goes down, you need to replace them with better and improved versions. So, if you have accumulated funds, you can replace the worn out assets with the new one without much investments and without bothering that particular current year. So, that is why it's a very important item for the profit and loss account, because it helps the business to retain funds and to accumulate these funds, which can be used whenever the asset wants to be replaced without burdening the profit for the current year. Now, after learning the objectives of the depreciation, the next that we proceed further is understanding the factors affecting the amount of depreciation. As we have been discussing, that depreciation is a kind of an expense which needs to be charged to your profit and loss account. Now, this amount of depreciation is being affected by certain factors. So, now we shall learn about what are the factors which are to be taken into consideration while calculating the amount of depreciation. Now, these factors can be identified as cost of the asset, the useful life of the asset, scrap value, and depreciable value of the asset. So, let us learn one by one what is meant by these different factors which needs to be accounted and taken into consideration when you calculate the amount of depreciation to be charged to your profit and loss account. Now, the first factor is the cost of the asset. Cost of the asset means the purchase price, the actual price which the business is incurring to acquire or to procure that particular fixed asset. But apart from the purchase price or the procurement price or the price of acquiring the asset, it also includes all the other expenses which are incurred for bringing that asset to use. So, to make it into workable position, you are also going to incur certain other expenses apart from the actual or the cost of acquisition. This can include the transportation cost or the installation cost. So, these costs would also be added when you compute your cost of asset. So, cost of asset will mean the actual purchase price of the asset, the transportation cost or loading, sometimes if it requires the loading of the asset to your factory premises or to your production area. So, the cost of that loading that you are incurring, as well as if you are incurring any amount on putting it into use or making it workable in terms of the installation amount, that would also be a part of the cost of the asset for the business. Second factor to be considered is the useful life of the asset. Now, every asset which the business acquires has a certain useful life. What is useful life? The expected number of years for which the asset can be put to use. Whenever you buy an asset, it has a certain useful life. So, that useful life is what is an important consideration when you calculate the amount of depreciation, and it's an estimated amount. Third factor is the scrap value. Scrap value is the residual value. That is, when the asset, when it is not of much use or its productivity has declined, then it needs to be replaced by a better version or with a new asset. Now, it will be sold to the scrap dealer. So, the amount which you are able to get from the scrap dealer is what is referred to as the scrap value of the asset. And the last factor is the depreciable value of the asset. So, the depreciable value is the cost of the asset minus the scrap value. And we just learnt about how the cost of the asset is calculated. So, the cost of asset minus whatever residual value or the scrap value that you are able to get after selling it to the scrap dealer needs to be subtracted from the cost of asset, and what you get is the depreciable value of the asset. Now, this is what is depreciable value of the asset, cost of the asset minus the scrap value. Now, let us take a small example to understand that what is the depreciable value of an asset or how it is computed. So, let us take this example. A generator was purchased for rupees 5 lakh, rupees 1500 was paid for crane for its loading, rupees 7000 was paid for transporting it to the factory, and rupees 2000 was spent on its unloading at the factory. The generator was estimated to run for 10 years and thereafter would be sellable for rupees 60,000, and we need to compute the depreciable value of the asset. So, for the purpose of computing the depreciable value of the asset, first we need to determine that what is the cost of the asset. And I just explained to you that when you compute the cost of the asset, apart from the purchase price or the procurement price, you have to add all the other expenses which the business is incurring for making the asset or bringing the asset to its workable form. Now, as it is evident from the question that you have a purchase price of 5 lakh rupees on the generator, then there are expenses on loading to an extent of 1500, Then there are transportation expenses for 7,000, and then there are also expenses on unloading. So the sum total of 5 lakh plus 1500 plus 7,000 and plus 2,000, which makes it a total of 5,10,500, would be the total cost of the asset. And from this, in order to determine the depreciable value of the generator, we deduct the scrap value. And in the question, the scrap value mentioned to us is that when you sell it to the scrap dealer, you are able to realize 60,000 after the useful life of the asset. So from this cost of 5,10,500, we subtract the scrap value of 60,000 and we get an amount of 4,50,500. So this becomes the total depreciable value of the generator which the business would be charging now to the profit and loss account over the useful life of the asset. So it is not that you're going to charge this entire amount of 4,50,500 in the same year in which the generator is being bought, but now we will divide this into the useful life of the asset and we will learn more about it, that how this is to be bifurcated and how this is to be divided and how the amounts are to be charged to your profit and loss account over the useful life of the asset under the topic on methods of charging depreciation. So we just learned about how the depreciable value of the asset is computed, and this would be charged over the useful life of the asset in the profit and loss account. Now, what we have learned up till now is related to the theoretical aspects of depreciation, that was understanding the meaning and the concept of depreciation, what are the causes of depreciation, with what objectives and aims depreciation is charged to our financial books of accounts. And then we also learnt about the factors affecting depreciation and the calculation of the depreciable value of the asset. Now, in the next part on depreciation, we would be talking in detail and learning about the accounting aspects related to the methods of charging depreciation. So, once this depreciable value is calculated, how it is to be charged in the books of accounts over the useful life would be taken up in the second part. Thank you for listening.